Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Rara Anggita from Office Administration Education Class A in 2019. On this occasion, I would like to present an internship report in Administration Subsection of the Asset Division at Suku Dinas Bina Marga, East Jakarta Administration City. Previously, I would like to thank you for Mr. Roni Faslah as my internship supervisor. Let's move on the first discussion. Internship background. Improving the quality of human resources is one of the components to achieve development goals and reduce unemployment, which is still high. One thing the industry needs is human resources who are educated, reliable, and able to meet challenges. Therefore, internships are needed so that students can improve their intellectual, social, academic, and career development. In order to equip students with real experience in the business and industrial world, the Office Administration Education Study Program at the State University of Jakarta organizes an internship program. The internship program is one of the courses, the curriculum of the Faculty of Economics, State University of Jakarta, which aims to give students a more comprehensive picture of the real world of work, while at the same time providing opportunities for students to apply the theory they have learned during lecture activities. Place and time. Practitioners carry out internship at Suku Dinas Bina Marga, East Jakarta Administration City, which is located at the East Jakarta Mayor's Office, Dr. Sumana Street, No. 1, Pulau Gadung, Cakung, East Jakarta. Practitioners carry out an internship for 40 days from February 2nd until March 31st, 2022. History of Suku Dinas Bina Marga. Suku Dinas Bina Marga is a service unit in the implementation of clan development efforts in the East Jakarta Administration City. Suku Dinas is led by sub-department head, who is under and responsible to the head of service and is operationally coordinated by the mayor. Prior to 2015, the affairs of clan development and water management in the DKI Jakarta province were handled by one service, namely the DKI Jakarta Provincial Public Works Department. However, considering the increasing workload, in order to provide the best service to the community in terms of community development and water management, these affairs were separated to be carried out by separated organizations, namely the Clan Development Service and the Water Management Service. Vision of Suku Dinas Bina Marga is Jakarta Administration City, high-quality infrastructure for an advanced, human, sustainable, and culture Jakarta. And the mission, 1. Providing quality and international class clan development infrastructure, 2. Making clan development infrastructure one of the important factors supporting the increase in the use of mass transportation, 3. Maintain a stable level of clan development infrastructure service and meet minimum service standards, and 4. Providing clan development infrastructure with good design, friendly for people with disabilities, culture, and environmentally friendly. Next, the organizational structure. Suku Dinas Bina Marga, East Jakarta Administration City, is led by the head of the service tribe named Mr. Benhat Hutajulu. Then, under it there is an administration subsection led by Mrs. Sarina as the head of the administration subsection. Then, under it there is a sub-district implementing unit and 3 sections led by Mr. Niki Haikal as the head of the planning section, Mr. Budi Cahyawardoyo as section head of roads, bridge, and road equipment, Mr. Abdul Jabbar as head of section for city utilities and public street lighting and infrastructure. Then, underneath there are staff from each division. Field of work. During the internship, practitioners working on 3 fields of work. 1. Archives. The work carried out by the practitioner in the field of archives includes recording incoming and outgoing letters into the archive book, disposing letters, distributing letters, sorting documents, and classifying letters. 2. Administration. The work carried out by the practitioner in the administration field includes imputing road and bridge material, imputing the work order number, checking the population identification number for subsidized food recipients, and imputing the employee population identification number. And 3. Office technology. The work carried out by the practitioner in the field of office technology includes duplicating documents by photocopying or scanning, printing documents with a printer, splitting and merging document digitally with website application. Work implementation. During the internship, the practitioner does 12 types of work. 1. Managing incoming letter. The practitioner works with receiving incoming letters to the administration subsection, which is then recorded in the archive book. Incoming letters usually come from 10 sub-districts in East Jakarta. 2. Disposition of letters. Letters addressed to more than one recipient will be subject to letter disposition. In this activity, the practitioner is tasked with recording letters into the disposition sheet. 3. Distribution of letter. In this activity, the practitioner works with delivering letters to the intended department, then asks the recipient of the letter to sign and write the date they received the letter in the expedition book. 4. Duplicate document. Document duplication can be done by photocopying or scanning. Usually, the duplicate documents include a letter of request for goods, an incoming letter from the sub-district, and a disposition sheet with legal size HPS paper. 5. Splitting and merging documents. In this activity, the practitioner works with splitting and merging documents in PDF format. Usually, the document is work or the letter. To make the work easier, the practitioner uses a website application called I Love PDF. 6. Tidy up documents. In this activity, the practitioner works with tidying up the documents in the assistant goods manager rooms. The practitioner separates the document into 6 parts, namely asset, inventory, minutes of handover and other minutes, letters of request for goods, invitation, and incoming letters. Then the document is entered into the folder. 7. Inputting incoming and outgoing goods distribution data. The practitioner works to input material assets that are released in January and February, especially for roads and bridge. This input is divided into 11 sections covering 10 sub-districts in East Jakarta and 1 sub-department of Hikwise, and 8 recap items on roads and bridge inventory cards. After inputting the expenditure of road and bridge material, next the practitioner recap the data into the inventory card that has been provided. 9. Entering the population identification number in Excel payroll data for other service provider individual. In this activity, the practitioner works to input the population identification number of road and bridge officer, draftman, city utility infrastructure and facilities, and public street lighting. 10. Entering the work order number and population identification number in the Excel list of subsidized food recipients. In this activity, the practitioner works with inputting the work order number and population identification number in the Excel list of subsidized food recipients. 11. Sorting document. In this activity, the practitioner works to spread the letter of request for goods for the public street lighting section, in which there is a request for goods in the form of a 40-watt Panasonic armature and stud, and then the letter is inserted into a folder. And the last, recap the authority of the technical implementing officer for activities. The practitioner works to enter the activity technical implementation officer, activity code, description, package, and value in the Excel that has been provided. Obstacle encountered. In each implementation, the practitioner encounters several obstacles. 1. Don't understand terms in the office. Don't understand division or job abbreviation and the names of the material contained in the asset. For example, when the practitioner is given the task of giving a letter to the PSUK section, the practitioner doesn't know the meaning of the abbreviation PSUK, so that the practitioner feels confused. 2. Data difference. The goods requested by the sub-district or service tribe through the goods request letter are not written in detail. Sometimes, the amount of material stock in the stock of name is different from that in the warehouse. And the last, 3. Photocopy machine often error. Paper to be copied often gets stuck in the machine and this can hinder work, especially if the file to be duplicated is quite a lot. Of course, it will take longer to process. how to overcome obstacle. To deal with the first obstacle, practitioner take the initiative to find out the meaning of the term via the internet or ask the staff directly. As said by Handano in 2008, that initiative is an individual's ability to produce something new or original or a problem solving. In overcoming the obstacle faced by the practitioner regarding ignorance of terms in the office, the practitioner tries to take the initiative and also continues to learn to develop a sense of initiative. To deal with the second obstacle, practitioner rely on communication to overcome obstacle in terms of data difference. The practitioner confirm the existing data by asking directly or through social media such as WhatsApp to communicate with the staff or warehouse head. With communication, the practitioner gets information and answer regarding the obstacle faced by the practitioner, so that the practitioner can continue to complete his work. Just as the definition of communication said Wibowo in 2017, communication is the exchange of information between the sender and the receiver and draw conclusion as a perception of the meaning of something between the individuals involved, also referred to as the interpersonal exchange of information and understanding. To deal with the third obstacle, practitioner work hard to stay patient and not give up so that this work can be complete on time even though the machine often errors. As said Kusuma, Triatna, and Permana in 2012, hard work is a term that covers an ongoing effort or never give up in completing the work that is the task to completion. Gap theory and practice. The gap occurs in the recording of incoming and outgoing letters, which is still done manually, namely by recording into the agenda book. Meanwhile, the practitioner has studied the management of incoming and outgoing mail archives digitally through a mail management application met with PHP and MySQL in the document processing application course. According to Pienza and Garnida in 2013, explained the electronic archive management is the management of various types of document in organization that use computer programs for data storage. This mail management application can save space and make it easier for employees to manage mail. In accordance with the theory state Sofia in 2017, with the existence of electronic archives in office activities, it can make it easier for employees to manage archives, both active archives and inactive archives. Conclusion. The internship, which was carried out at Suku Dinas Bina Marga is Jakarta Administration City in Administration Subsection of the Asset Division, was very providing experience and added insight for the practitioner about the picture of the world of work that the practitioner had never known before. The internship program is also useful for practitioners to apply the theory they have learned during lectures and prepare themselves before entering the world of work in the future. Recommendation for Faculty of Economics, State University of Jakarta. The first, improving the quality of academic service as a whole, especially at the internship preparation stage, such as giving briefings to students who will carry out internship. And the second, the Faculty of Economics should urgently provide training to students who will carry out internship so that they can be more skilled in carrying out work in internship. And the last, it is advisable for the Faculty of Economics to monitor students during the internship by visiting directly to the student practice to ensure the performance and supervision of students. Recommendation for Suku Dinas Bina Marga is Jakarta Administration City. The first, the company should be able to provide more facilities in work such as providing computers for each employee or student who is doing an internship. The second, checking office facilities such as computers, photocopy machine, and printer machine so that work can be complete in a timely and efficient manner. And the third, it is hoped that the company and the State University of Jakarta cooperate to make it easier for students who will carry out internship at Suku Dinas Bina Marga, East Jakarta Administration City. Okay, that is all from me. I would like to apologize if there is mistake. Thank you so much for your time and your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.